Good afternoon. Welcome to the state capitol. It will be a busy place this time next week, but I appreciate you being here today. We have three judges to be sworn into office this afternoon. And we will proceed in the order of the Superior Court Judgeship for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit, the Superior Court Judgeship for the Clayton Judicial Circuit, and the State Court Judgeship for Clayton County. At the beginning, I want to welcome the justices of the Supreme Court. I see Justice Namias, who is here, and any judges of the Court of Appeals who might be here as well. Thank you for being here. To local judges and local courthouse officials from the respective areas of our state who are here for this ceremony, thank you all for being here as well. The first order of business is the introduction of my selection for the judicial post of Superior Court Judge of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. For purposes of introducing the soon-to-be judge is my good friend, the Honorable David Ralston, Speaker of the Georgia House of Representatives, a gentleman that I have had the pleasure and the opportunity of serving with during the entire time I have been the governor of this state. Speaker Ralston, the platform is yours.
Thank you very much, Governor, and members of the judiciary that are here. It was in the spring of 2010, I received a phone call from a young lawyer that I had the pleasure of meeting a number of times over the years, and he was calling to ask my advice about running for political office. Well, I talked him out of that. And I talked him into coming to work as a lawyer in my law practice. And today that young lawyer is embarking on a new and exciting chapter in his life as he takes the oath of office as a Superior Court Judge for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. I am confident that Clint Bearden will bring the same qualities to the bench that he has demonstrated as a lawyer: a steady hand, a sharp legal mind, a strong desire to serve his community, and the ability to touch lives in a positive way. The decisions of a judge are far-reaching and profound. That is why we insist on our judges having the highest standards of integrity, fairness, impartiality, and an absolute commitment to adhering to the rule of law and doing justice. Governor Deal, you have chosen well. I have observed carefully the work and values of Clint Bearden. I know he will bring honor to the bench. I am confident that he will make the right and just call regardless of how tough those decisions may be. It is a real honor for me at this time to present to you the judge designate for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit, my friend, Clint Bearden.
If you will raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Clint Bearden,
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I have been a resident of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit.
That I have been a resident of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit.
For the time required by law.
For the time required by law.
That I will administer justice.
That I will administer justice.
Without respect to person.
Without respect to person.
And do equal rights to the poor and rich.
Do equal rights to the poor and the rich.
And that I will faithfully and impartially.
I will faithfully and impartially
discharge and perform.
Discharge and perform.
All the duties incumbent on me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As judge of the superior courts of this state.
As judge of the superior courts of this state.
According to the best of my ability and understanding.
According to the best of my ability and understanding.
And agreeably to the laws and constitution of this state.
Agreeably to the laws and constitution of this state.
And the constitution of the United States.
The constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
As I'm thinking about being here today, as over the last few days and with a new year, a lot of serious thought has gone on in my mind. It's a great opportunity that lies ahead, a great chance to do a lot of positive things. And in a moment of kind of lightheartedness, I was thinking that it's a good start to the new year when the Georgia Bulldogs winning the Rose Bowl is the second best thing that's happened this year. So I just say that I'm honored to be here this day, and with Governor Deal swearing me in would be an understatement. The work of Governor Deal, the legacy of what he and his team, the members of the General Assembly under Speaker Ralston, and the members of the House and Senate, judges and their staffs across the state that have worked over the last 7-8 years to advance accountability courts and to help create drastic change for the positive in our state's legal system and our state's criminal justice system, that's been the inspiration for me to be here today. I've sit through drug court graduations and health court graduations, and I laugh and I cry and I leave with the revival of my soul, because that's everything that's good about law, and the ability to have a positive influence upon people's lives and to help improve the lives of those in their community. I'm grateful for the chance to do that today. Grateful for the folks that have helped me be here, helped me achieve this. Speaker Ralston, you have been the greatest mentor and you've been the greatest friend, and I am forever loyal and forever grateful for what you've been able to help me, guide me. I hope that I have a small fraction of the wisdom and the patience and the sage counsel that you've been able to give over the years. Thank you very much. To the judges of the Appalachian Circuit, Judge Worcester and Judge Weaver are here. I don't know if Judge Priest and Judge Mercier, I think, is tied up in oral argument. She was one of our judges. You have been a great influence upon my life. I appreciate the wisdom that you've shared as a young lawyer to help guide me and help me become a better attorney. To the judges of the Northeastern Circuit and to the staff, I am beyond excited to go to work. Northeastern Circuit is one of the greatest judicial circuits in the state of Georgia. They have had a history of some of the most well-respected judges, and that continues to be true today. Judge Fuller, Judge Goslin, Judge Oliver, Judge Deal, it's a pleasure to be able to work with you and to be able to learn from you. And I'm beyond excited to get to work on Monday morning with criminal pleas. I'm ready to go. To my friends that are here, certainly, not lost upon me that I have met so many great friends over the years of my life. There's no way that that's been left to chance. I feel very firmly and believe that God has guided me in my life, and along the way he has placed some wonderful people that I'm glad to call friends today. You all inspire me. I have so many friends that have accomplished so much, and I know that they're going to go on to continue to accomplish great things. I'm grateful to call you friends. I'm grateful for your support, and I'm proud to have you here with me today. Lastly, I want to thank my family. I couldn't be here today without my mom and dad, who have worked so hard to provide for my sister and myself. They always strove to make sure that our life was better than their life, to make sure that we had the opportunities for education, to be able to go to college and to achieve our dreams. And I'm grateful for them, grateful for my sister and brother-in-law that are here, my mother-in-law that's here. I have a wonderful extended family, aunts and uncles and cousins, that I've been blessed to be able to grow up with my entire life and have involved in my life, and I am so thankful for them. Most importantly, I'm thankful for my wife. She is the love of my life, and she has been, we've been together for 15 years, married for 11 and a half, and every night I go to bed, and I'm thankful in my prayers that God has blessed me with her in my life. She is a wonderful mother to our children, and the children are the highlight of our lives. I know every day to be able to come home from the stresses of a law practice and from the stresses of court and trying to do the best for your clients and trying to do the best for justice, to walk in and have your children run up to you and give you a hug is about the best therapy that I could ever imagine. So I am grateful to have my family, the support, and I'm excited to go to work. I'm thankful for this opportunity and ready to hit the ground running. Thank y'all so much.
Well, Judge Bearden, I have it on good advice that the judges of this circuit are waiting for you to get there, and you won't have to worry about an agenda. They already have it ready and printed on your desk. Since we have three, we're going to do the photographs at the conclusion of the swearing-in ceremonies for the other two judges that remain. The next ceremony will be for the swearing-in of Kathryn L. Powers as the Superior Court Judge in the Clayton Judicial Circuit. For purposes of introducing her, and she already is a judge, and I was told by my staff just as before I came in that today, a year ago today, I swore you in as the State Court Judge of Clayton County. And my comment was, well, you sure didn't get enough time for a retirement benefit. But for purposes of introducing her, the Honorable Deborah C. Benefield, retired Chief Judge of the Superior Court of the Clayton Judicial Circuit. Judge.
Thank you, Governor. I appreciate that. My name is Deborah Benefield, and I was on the Superior Court bench for quite a while in Clayton County and enjoyed every bit of it, just as I know that Katie will as well. Judge Kathryn Powers currently presides over her state court cases as well as the DUI Accountability Court. Previously, she was an executive assistant district attorney and successfully tried high-profile cases and was sole counsel in all child murder cases, and many of those she tried in my courtroom at the time, and always did an awesome job. She gave back to her community that she loved. In fact, she was born and raised in Clayton County. Not many of us, including me, can say that, but she was. She mentored scores of young adults in the mock trial program, some of whom now, because of her efforts, practice law in all areas of the region. I've known Katie for many years. I spent my entire career in Clayton County, and I now serve as a senior judge across the state. All judges have a reputation. For those who strive to get it right and provide fair hearings for litigants, that reputation is very important. As a judge, I would never recommend someone for such an important bench if I was not confident they were the best person for the job. I do not hesitate to recommend Judge Powers to you as the best of the best. I assure you, she will not disappoint. There is no doubt she will get the law right. Just as importantly, if not more so, she will have empathy for all of those who come before her and will not take their legal issues nor their lives lightly. I'm thankful to Governor Deal. I wrote him a letter to Governor Deal for appointing Judge Powers. You made a wonderful choice in adding a top-notch judge to the existing bench. The state and Superior Court benches have earned their reputations as two of the finest benches in the state in Clayton County. I cannot wait to see what they do. It is always tough to walk away from a community and a profession. A little over a year ago, that's what I did, after 24 years on the Superior Court bench. To know that someone like Katie is taking that on that position makes the transition much easier. I know that the community I have loved and served is in capable and caring hands. I would be remiss without reading my favorite quote, as I'm sure you're expecting, by Theodore Roosevelt. I would not disappoint. The credit belongs to those who are actually in the arena, who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, and spends themselves in a worthy cause, who at best know the triumph of high achievement, and who at worst, if they fail while daring greatly, so that their place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat. As I risk an understatement, I will tell you, Judge Powers is neither timid nor a cold soul. And because of that, I am proud to introduce Judge Kathryn Powers to you as the newest Superior Court judge on the Clayton County bench. And you may thank you.
I
Judge, if you'll raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Kathryn Lorian Powers.
Solemnly swear.
Solemnly swear.
That I have been a resident.
That I have been a resident.
Of the Clayton Judicial Circuit.
Of the Clayton Judicial Circuit.
For the time required by law.
For the time required by law.
That I will administer justice.
That I will administer justice.
Without respect to person.
Without respect to person.
And do equal rights to the poor and rich.
And do equal rights to the poor and rich.
And that I will faithfully and impartially.
That I will faithfully and impartially.
Discharge and perform.
Discharge and perform.
All the duties incumbent on me.
All the duties incumbent on me.
As judge of the Superior Courts of this state.
As judge of the Superior Courts of this state.
According to the best of my ability and understanding.
According to the best of my ability and understanding.
And agreeably to the laws and constitution of this state.
And agreeably to the laws and constitution of this state.
And the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Good afternoon. First, it is an honor to be standing before all of you today, and I would not be here without my faith in God. And so my first thanks goes to the Lord for allowing me to be in a position to serve the place that I love. Second, to Governor Deal, I am humbled and appreciative of the trust and confidence that you have placed in me to my appointment to the State Court of Clayton County and now to my appointment of the Superior Court. It is an amazing thing to be able to wake up every morning in your hometown, drive down the street past your friends, your neighbors, your church members, and your parents, and be able to serve the community that you love. That's an honor that not many individuals are able to have, and it's one that I am so grateful to have. I love Clayton County because it has nurtured me, it has grown me, it has supported me, and it is who I am. You see, when you grow up in your hometown, you have a lot of nicknames. Katie, Kathryn, Katie Kate, which thankfully is not used anymore in the judge meetings, prosecutor, judge, and perhaps a few others. But one of the proudest names that I have ever asked is, are you Bill Powers' granddaughter? You see, my grandfather was the chief probation officer for the Clayton Judicial Circuit. He had the good foresight all those years ago to hire Chief Chiquita Dean for her many years of service. And he would wake up every morning at the old courthouse building and several mornings during the week and take in chicken biscuits, homemade chicken biscuits that my granny had made, sausage biscuits as well. And he'd bring them in and he would sell them to support our home church of Jones Memorial United Methodist. And so when people ask me, are you Bill Powers' granddaughter, it's not because they want to talk about his legal experience or how he was as a probation officer. It's because they remember those biscuits. Had to sadly disappoint them and tell them that those genes did not pass down. But that type of love for my county and my hometown is an example that has been set by my family. I've got a couple of folks that I would like to thank today. First, I'd like to thank Stephanie and my parents and my immediate family who are here today and those in attendance. Without your love and support, there's no way that I would be standing before you. Second, there are many people whose advice and counsel along this journey and during the appointment process that I could not have done it without them, but just a couple that I'd like to recognize. Judge Benefield, thank you for the introduction, and Judge Carbo, who has been my mentor on the state court and was cheering on the dogs in Pasadena, California, and I agree that sometimes that might rank above getting back here. Judge Schwall and Mr. Stevens, Judge Teske and Justice Carley, Judge Collier, I am honored to be appointed to your seat. And if I serve with one-tenth of the wisdom that you have exhibited over the past 20-plus years, then I will have considered it a success. I'm appreciative of your guidance. I think maybe that you will have wished that you'd use some of that wisdom to change your cell phone number maybe in the next couple of months, but I am appreciative of all the help and counsel that you have given. During the past year, I've been honored to serve with some of the best state court judges in the state. And there's a special thanks to Chief Judge Linda Cowan for her leadership of that court and to make sure that we continue it in the right direction. That has been invaluable. I'm also honored to join a bench with a tremendous reputation for fairness. I would be remiss if I did not thank Jamie and Jennifer and Kim, who've made the past year a complete joy, and Mrs. Graham Lawson, our elected district attorney, who gave a shot to that high school mock trial student all those years ago and allowed me to come home and serve my home county. She was actually the judge of my first round, and I'm not going to tell you how many years ago because we don't want to give away Mrs. Graham Lawson's age. To our delegation, our esteemed delegation, I appreciate all of your support. To our mayors who are present, our Board of Education, and our county leadership, both Judge Jones-Parker and I immensely appreciate your support here and in the continuing months to come. To my lifelong friends, fantastic neighbors, and might as well be my family, I love all of you and I'm so glad you're here. My mock trial students are actually present. Like, they were able to get here with a big yellow limousine. So I'm glad that they are present. I would like to point out that this does not exempt you from practice later today. My pastor is present, my leadership Clayton, family, and women of Clayton County. I'm so glad that all these folks from all these parts of our lives are here to celebrate this day. Luke 12:48 reads, unto over whom so much ever is given, of him shall much be required. Governor Deal, I know that much has been given, and I also know that much has been required. And I'll let you know personally that I will not let you down. Thank you so much.
Well, I couldn't elevate Judge Powers without creating a vacancy on the State Court of Clayton County. Funny how things like that work that way. But I was honored to be given the opportunity to appoint someone else to that position, a very qualified lady. And for purposes of introducing her to you at this time, I'm going to call on the Honorable Keith Gamage, the Fulton County Solicitor General, for purposes of that introduction.
Good afternoon. I paused for a moment when I walked up here to just take a look at Shalonda Jones-Parker. It is a great and high privilege for me to stand before this great body of citizens and have the honor as the Fulton County Solicitor General to introduce my friend and colleague Shalonda Jones-Parker, who many of us affectionately call, and I don't know how often I'll get to do that again publicly, but we often call her, out of great love, SJP. Some of what I want you to know about soon-to-be Judge Shalonda Jones-Parker is that she matriculated through the University of Memphis, that she will be well qualified for one reason, because of her educational pedigree, that she obtained a bachelor's in English with a concentration on professional writing at the University of Memphis, that she finished at the top of her class, that she then matriculated through the University of Tennessee College of Law, focusing at that time on trial advocacy and dispute resolution. Those experiences will bode her well and serve her well and serve Clayton County and Georgia well when she takes the bench. She successfully wrote on law review while in law school, engaged in mock trial, and then upon graduation was able to obtain a highly coveted clerkship, judicial clerkship, with the Honorable William Koch, Jr. in Memphis, Tennessee. She's practiced as a civil litigator, running her own firm, balancing budgets, and building a successful practice. She's been a criminal practitioner, is how I first met her when we were in the trenches of the courtrooms in the great county of Clayton in the great state of Georgia. And let me tell you what I recall about her in those first meetings where we did battle one against the other. She always cared. She always cared about justice. Later, I was blessed to become under the tutelage of the great Tasha Mosley, Solicitor General of Clayton County. I was blessed to be promoted to Chief Assistant, and then we were blessed and wise to hire Shalonda Jones-Parker as a young prosecutor. And let me tell you all, she had the most steady hand and the highest aim toward pursuing justice. Never was it for her a desire to move cases. It was a desire to do justice with mercy, with kindness, with compassion, and with excellence. One story I will briefly share. When I served as chief assistant and was Ms. Jones-Parker's direct supervisor, she came to me as we worked every day together and said, I've got this tough DUI case. And I think justice just demands that we reduce the charge because the evidence, I just don't believe because of some evidentiary issues we'll be able to prove it. But I want to make sure that the accused gets justice, gets an opportunity for punishment, gets an opportunity for rehabilitation, and that the public is made safer. As we talked about that case, I could see her welling up with emotion because she cares so much. I told her to consider a couple of other things. She went back, tried the case, and won. Here's where the moral is. A good judge must be able to listen to others. She's a leader. She will be a leader. She went back in that courtroom, tried that case. The defendant was convicted, and then at sentencing, she did not attempt to ratchet up the penalty. She made an offer to the good judge that was there that was rooted in the facts of the case and the defendant's history. What I learned from that is that aside from being a good listener, she will work hard and she will take direction well, and here the direction will be the letter of the law. But she will see from the law the true object of justice, and that is to find solutions, both criminally and civilly, to the problems that face our citizens. It is great that she is ascending to the bench. Thank you, Governor Deal. In the backdrop of Governor Deal's historic criminal justice reform, which we all embrace, it is with great pride that I say congratulations, and it has been an honor to introduce you, Judge SJP.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank God for allowing me to be here today. During this appointment process, I never asked him to make me judge. I asked him to let his will be done, to put me where he wants me to be. I'd like to thank Governor Deal. Thank you, sir, for using your precious appointment power and having faith in me. It is something that I will remember the rest of my life, and I will not let you down. To my husband, Trey, thank you for taking this ride with me. My husband is a very quiet and reserved person socially, so all of this attention is a lot for him today. But hopefully, being the spouse of a judge will help us become closer in our love and in our marriage, and I look forward to that. How did I get here? I never imagined myself as a judge. Wasn't on my to-do list. I always wanted to be a lawyer, though, ever since I was 7 years old. And my grandmother told me what a lawyer did on a television show, my grandmother who raised me. And a country girl from Arlington, Tennessee, you don't see a whole lot of African-American female attorneys. But my family supported my dream. My family supported my dream along with very precious teachers. Why? How would I know that that dream would lead me here to being on the Clayton County bench? How would I know that? How would I know that losing that same grandmother during my first semester of law school would cause me not to want to return to Memphis, not to want to return to my hometown? How could I know that I would meet Twyla Harris in law school and make her my big sister and follow her back here to her home in Georgia, where I would apply for a judge, I'm sorry, where I would apply for a prosecutor position in Clayton County? How could I know that Tasha Mosley would interview me for that position and recommend to Keith Martin, then Solicitor General, to hire me? How could I possibly know that I would enter private practice with Twyla Harris and that would cause me to take on a case that led to me having my star witness, who turned out to be my husband, Grady Parker III. And lo and behold, how could I possibly know that he would be from Clayton County all his life? So after that series of events, ladies and gentlemen, and the prayer that I made to God to put me where he wants me to be, I have no doubt that I am where I'm supposed to be. Who helped me get here? I certainly didn't get here alone. Sir Isaac Newton once wrote that if I have seen a little further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants. If I have gone a little further in my life, it is because I too stand on the shoulders of giants. My husband and my children. You've seen my husband, Trey. Unfortunately, our son, Prince, could not be here today. My stepson, he lives in Virginia with his mother, and quite frankly, he didn't want to mess up his perfect attendance record or miss a basketball game. So I know he's here with me in spirit. And my son, Pierce. My son, Pierce, was only with me inside of my body about 7 months. However, during that time, he's changed who I was as a person. He's not with me in body, but he's certainly with me everywhere I go. I also stand on the shoulders of my family, many who've made it here today. My mother, my father, my stepfather, my grandmother, siblings, my in-laws, my cousins, my nieces, my uncle, all of you. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for your love and support over the years. I stand on the shoulders of my friends who are like family, people like Chandra Lewis, Judge Margaret Spencer, Denise Rodney, Twyla Harris Brown, Andrea Allaby, people who have supported me and loved me like I was their sister. I'm forever grateful for you, and I know you will keep me humble. I stand on the shoulder of my past employers, people who gave me a chance, like Justice William Cope, who was a former Tennessee Supreme Court justice, who gave me that opportunity as a judicial clerk so that I could gain the perspective that most attorneys don't have, and quite frankly, to serve my career. People like Keith Martin, who gave me a chance to prosecute for the first time, who has been instrumental to me throughout this process. I stand on the shoulders of Tasha Mosley, who I can now say is my former boss. I won't say that in a bad way. Tasha gave me a chance, and she listened to the very wise counsel of Keith Gamage and brought me back to prosecuting about 4 years ago. And for that, I'll forever be in her debt of gratitude. Keith Gamage, I think you all know why I chose him to give my introduction. But Keith planted the seed to apply for a judgeship to me a couple of years ago. And of course, I brushed him off. Jones-Parker, it would behoove you to apply. I just have to know Keith, but I love you. Thank you for being my mentor. I'm forever in your gratitude. Judge Powers, whose seat I will fill during this last year, you're going to be a hard act to follow. This lady has come into our court, same court where I prosecuted. She's worked very hard, tried cases. She set a very high example to follow. She seeks excellence. And I want to be in the presence of anyone who seeks to be excellent. So thank you. My Clayton County Solicitor General's office family, who are here in full effect this afternoon, thank you. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for supporting me. Because of you, I've become a better attorney, a better colleague, and a better person. There's so many others whose shoulders I stand on. I could stand here all afternoon, but I just want to thank you all for your vote of confidence and your support. And what will the citizens of Clayton County get when they get Judge SJP? I once heard that if you do a job for free, if you love your job, you would do it for free. Unfortunately, I can't do this job for free. But anyone who knows me knows that I love the law. I am passionate for justice. And I realized throughout this process that I've learned so much about the law and about myself when I made mistakes, when I sought help before making bigger mistakes. And it's in those times it made me realize what my true character is. As a judge, Clayton County will receive someone who knows when to ask for help, will receive someone who wants to do a good job. To receive someone who loves this county that she has lived in for the past 13 years. I'm looking forward to working with our state court bench. And I'm so ready to get to work. Thank you all for being here.
About y'all, but I think after hearing from those three individuals that I've made some good choices. Don't you? There's something under here. Y'all just hold on. Something that's under there. It's not what I was looking for. Those of you who have attended swearing-in ceremonies such as this before, you know that we have a tradition of presenting to the newly selected judges to give them a plaque with the appropriate gavel and an inscription of the day, etc., that commemorates this ceremony today. And I always tell the judges and remind them that these plaques are made by inmates in our state prison system. And I do that to remind you that you are to do justice. And even though there are those who do violate our laws, we wish they didn't, but they will and will continue to do so, unfortunately, that they all have some redeeming social values. And hopefully these plaques will remind you of that. Now we're going to move into the photograph section of this ceremony, and we'll do it in the order in which we proceeded with the swearing-ins. So for those of you who are want to have photographs with Judge Bearden, if you will sort of move over here to the side and get ready for your time before the camera, and we will proceed in that order as we move through this process. Thank you again for everybody being here today.
Thank you. I start tomorrow. All right. I'll be down in the area.
Curtis Brink. How's your son doing?
Great.
Good, good. You need a girl now.
Today, Governor Nathan Deal swore in Clint Bearden as a Superior Court judge of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. His action calls into question the entire judicial nominating process of the state of Georgia. Clint Bearden was the only nominee out of six who was opposed by the people of the state of Georgia, both as at the Judicial Nominating Commission and as well opposition directly to Governor Deal and his office. Nevertheless, Governor Deal swore him in today because of his political connections. Clint Bearden was the and is the law partner for Speaker of the House David Ralston. He interned for Governor Deal when he was a U.S. Congressman, and he clerked for Governor Deal's son, Jason Deal, on the Superior Court bench. All of this calls into question the process of whether or not this is really a legitimate appointment. The people will have a chance to decide in 2 years when they will get a chance as to whether or not they want to elect Clint Bearden to this judgeship position.